A small Ohio college is seeing a spike in COVID-19 cases, and that means protocols are changing fast. 10TV's Brittany Bailey brings us to the latest from Cedarville University.
The students have been back here on campus for a little more than 2 weeks, and the COVID-19 case numbers among students have been steadily climbing since then, now up to nearly 300.
We hope these plans that we've implemented are going to pay off and reduce the spread and bring us back to a more normal and manageable level.
Right now, Cedarville is managing by creating even more isolation space for students. That's on top of another space that already is full.
This wave will pass, and our commitment is to be on campus in person. We believe that's the best way to do discipleship.
When students returned to campus, there were no protocols in place, no vaccine requirement, no mask mandates.
Our initiative was to empower the students to make sound decisions that's best in their health in their best interests.
But that meant initially holding chapel in a space that can hold roughly 3,500 people at one time, almost the entire student population.
Honestly, when I came in the beginning, it was like 4,000 kids in one place, no mask, in a chapel. I was like, wow, these kids are obviously going to go higher. But now, once I feel like the mask is coming back, I feel like kind of comfortable, you know, with cases maybe going down.
But is it fair to say that people were not making those quote-unquote sound decisions that you wanted them to make when they came back to campus?
I don't know if that's the reason here. I think the Delta variant is so powerful, it swept through here quickly.
At last count, there were 281 positive cases, more than 7% of the student population. So now masks are required indoors, and as of Friday, students can choose to take classes online. The plan extends through at least September 7th.
Do we really think that 10 or 11 days of this protocol is going to fix everything?
That's a good question. I'm not a medical expert.
We should point out that these case numbers are only for students and do not include faculty and staff numbers. We know that means the numbers are higher on campus because the vice president herself is sick and the spokesman we interviewed on Zoom is in quarantine. Reporting in Cedarville, Brittany Bailey, 10TV News.
Brittany, thank you. We checked in with a few other area universities. Otterbein has seen 15 positive cases since August 1st. Out of those, only two were among the 1,000 students living on campus. Ohio Dominican also only has two active cases among its 1,500 students. And Kenyon College is reporting four positive cases, two students and two employees. And we should note all three of these schools have mask policies, and Kenyon students must be vaccinated.